In Black Ops 3's DLC season, we got to see our four characters, to quote Nikolai, ensnare their mortal souls. While they weren't actually dying in the overall sense, in the cutscenes we got to see the characters essentially kill off other versions of themselves. And while that was conveyed to be an emotional experience, especially in Der Eisendrache, it always had a level of optimism about it. These characters may be dying in the physical sense, but their souls are still vibrant and alive inside the summoning key. But things have begun to change in Black Ops 4, where the cycle is broken and death now has consequence. The games have told us Primis will fail and Ultimus will prevail. This is what I think these two quotes mean going forward in our zombie storyline. And well, spoiler alert, it's not all sunshine and rainbows for our crews, like we've seen in past games. If Black Ops 3 was meant to provide the brackets to the zombies storyline like Jason Blundell said it would, to wrap it up in a neat little package within the cycle, then BO4 is likely taking it to its final conclusion. This story that they're about to tell in BO4 has to start with the death of Blood of the Dead Richtofen in the ending cutscene. With this version of Tricky Rick gone, there are now only two left in the entirety of the zombies storyline moving forward with the cycle broken: Ultimus Richtofen and Great War Richtofen. And for a preview of their fates, we have to turn to a famous cipher that was located within Shadows of Evil. The cipher, and I'm sure you've heard it before, says this: "Although they have discovered the way, Primis will fail." Now, at the time, that was interpreted as, oh, they've discovered the way, what they have to do to ensnare their mortal souls, bring them all to the house, secure the souls for the kids, and everything will be hunky-dory after that. And then, of course, they fail once Monty keeps them going within the cycle. But the events of Black Ops 4, specifically within Blood of the Dead, proves that this really isn't what the cipher is talking about. The events leading up to securing the souls of the kids within Black Ops 3 wasn't discovered, it was revealed by the Cranorium. Something that seems to have been totally discovered by Primis. Something that they weren't expected to be able to accomplish, and that is, in fact, breaking the cycle. Although they have discovered the way to break the cycle, Primis will fail, seems to be the more accurate reading of the quote in the current sense. Now, of course, there's still questions here. We don't know how they managed to break the cycle yet. All we know is that it is, in fact, broken. So going forward with this broken cycle, leading to the true conclusion of the Aether storyline, Primis will fail. But of course, we have to mention that going forward, there are two separate versions of Primis that we have to keep track of, right? We have the Blood of the Dead crew minus their Richtofen, and then we have the post-war Primis crew that we assume initiated breaking the cycle. We've only seen Richtofen of that crew. We don't know where Takeo Dempsey and Nikolai of that crew are located, though we speculated that they might be in DLC 2 Nuketown. Definitely check that video out where we discuss the DLC 2 leaks down in the description. But we have to ask ourselves, when Treyarch tells us Primis will fail, which version of Primis do they mean? Well, it seems to me that there's three main options for how this is going to end. The first option, and the most heart-wrenching, is that Primis will fail in its entirety. That in some way, both the Primis crews that we know are active in the zombies storyline right now will be permanently killed off. They're going up against one of the ultimate powers in the universe in the form of Dr. Monty. In the Revelations ending cutscene, we saw the effects that the blood vials had. They simply meant that that version of Primis wouldn't be wiped from existence entirely when the world was freed of the Apothecan's wrath. But what the blood vials have a zero effect on is Dr. Monty's power over them. We saw in that Rev cutscene that Dr. Monty could will the Primis crew out of existence if he wanted to. Going up against a power like that, the blood vials are useless. And that's why we see in the Blood of the Dead ending cutscene where Great War Primis says the blood vials are no longer needed and proceeds to smash them on the ground and instructs the rest of the Blood of the Dead crew to do the same. In a fight with a being as powerful as Dr. Monty, there is bound to be some casualties, some kind of sacrifice along the way that will be needed to overcome such a powerful foe. Option one is that sacrifice will be the entirety of Primis, both Great War and Blood of the Dead versions, in order to rid the world of Dr. Monty once and for all. That's definitely the bleakest of the versions going forward. The permanent and final deaths of our four characters that we've been following since Origins. The other two options are theorizing the deaths of one or the other crew. Either the crew from Blood of the Dead will have to be sacrificed and fail, or the Great War Primis crew will have to be sacrificed and therefore fail. Of these two options, it seems much more likely to me that they would have the Great War Primis crew end up being the ones that are sacrificing themselves, rather than just the remnants of the Blood of the Dead crew. That would seem to be a better story in my eyes, and also kind of fit what happens in the Blood of the Dead ending cutscene, where if the Blood of the Dead Primis crew was in fact going to fail, they were going to sacrifice themselves in the battle with Dr. Monty, I'd think that Great War Richtofen would be a little bit more hesitant to give Nikolai the book which foretells future events to read. If he knew that version of Primis had to die in order for their battle against Dr. Monty to succeed, you'd think he'd want to keep it a little bit more hush-hush from that crew going forward, rather than telling them, yeah, we're leading you into death here. Instead, he hands the Chronorium to Nikolai to read his fate. But let's assume the worst here, that Primis will fail in its entirety, that both the Blood of the Dead and the Great War crews will be killed off at the end of Black Ops 4. What would that leave us? Where is the victory in seeing our favorite characters just killed off permanently? Well, in this sequence of events, while the Primis versions of our characters would be killed off, it still leaves another fan favorite group, the Ultimus crew, alive and kicking to savor in the victory over Dr. Monty. We get a bit of foreshadowing of this sequence when looking at some quotes on the walls of Classified, specifically taking into account the lines, "The Aether is not for us, Ultimus will prevail." Primis will fail, Ultimus will prevail. To me, what these quotes are doing is setting up the finale to Black Ops 4 to almost prepare us for the way this story is going to end, and they're going to do it via a nod to where they came from, to a callback, a celebration of their past by keeping the Ultimus crew alive when everything is all said and done. Putting ourselves in the minds of Treyarch, Jason Blundell, and Craig Houston, it seems to me that that would be a great way of kind of honoring, respecting where the mode has come from and where it is now, ending it with the OG4 crew that a large majority of this community fell in love with when they played the mode for the first time, that being the Ultimus crew, victorious over Dr. Monty, and the Primis crew, though they failed on their quest to stay alive through the battle, sacrificed themselves so that Ultimus will prevail. It's both a bleak and pretty picture, and we'll have to see whether it happens in Black Ops 4's DLC season. I'm not sure about you guys, but it seems like to me that Treyarch Zombies in its current kind of popular form can't exist with the Chaos storyline being the only entity present within future games. At least for me, it's the draw of the Aether storyline that keeps me coming back and playing Treyarch Zombies games. And without it, future releases will seem hollow in some way. Like something's missing that should be there, but isn't. In terms of my hopes on where Treyarch will in fact take this, is that when they say that Black Ops 4 will be the end of the Aether storyline, what they kind of really mean is that this is the end of the O4, that this is the end of Takeo, Nikolai, Dempsey, and Richtofen's story in all their versions, in all their forms, that their story concludes in Black Ops 4. We won't be playing as them ever again. But I hope they end their story in a way that allows the ethos of the Aether storyline to continue in the future. There is still another entirely independent, intact crew within the storyline, Victus, frozen in the cryopods within Blood of the Dead that are still alive and kicking, just waiting to be used again, that could have adventures within the Aether storyline going into the future. For me, it doesn't even necessarily have to be Victus, but just keep it within the Aether universe so that everything we know about the zombie storyline up to this point doesn't just get thrown away, discarded. That it's still relevant and that we can still reference it going into the future of the zombie storyline that we currently can't do in the Chaos storyline. With, make no mistake about it, Chaos being totally separate from the zombie storyline that we know of up to this point. That concludes this video, guys. If you enjoyed, be sure to smash that thumbs up button down below. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'd love to hear your opinions on where the story is going from here down in the comments. Do you agree with me? Do you have an alternative theory to explain these quotes? I'd love to hear them all down in the comments. But I want to thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you with another Zombies News video tomorrow. Peace.